All right, I have just a couple more, and then we're getting some questions that are coming in here.
Good.
What goes into a disposition of remains appointment?
That's a new one. And I always preface this telling a story about a famous baseball player, and some Red Sox fans maybe out there. I'm not one. I'm a Met fan. I'm not a Yankee fan, so you can't be too harsh. We suffer enough as Met fans. But looking at it, Ted Williams.
Yes.
When he died, had a will that in it said he wanted to be cremated, and he wanted to have his ashes sprinkled in the Gulf of Mexico, mm-hmm. off his fishing boat. He was a big fisherman.
Oh, okay.
And in the meantime, while he was in the hospital in his final illness, his son had a handwritten piece of paper mm-hmm. that his father purportedly signed, mm-hmm. saying that he wanted to be cryogenically frozen and preserved for posterity.
Oh.
They had a litigation. Uh-huh. The son also happened to get all the money from the estate, so uh-huh. he ended up winning.
Uh-huh.
And Ted Williams was, in fact, frozen and sits somewhere in a laboratory in Arizona.
I don't think I ever knew that.
And they actually have an HBO special that tracks this a little bit.
Is that right?
Ted Williams' life and what happened at the end.
Huh.
But you don't want things left to chance.
Right.
And so in New York, they enacted a statute about 5 years ago, which allows you to, again, appoint an agent.
Right.
And to give that agent instructions as to cremation, burial, services,
sure.
all the things that you know, I want to think about.
Right.
But boy, is it a relief to your family to have those things spelled out
right.
and to have one person in charge of making sure it all happens according to plan.
Absolutely.
So that's the disposition of remains appointment. Mm-hmm. We use it now in every consultation, regardless of age, mm-hmm. again. Okay. And people have gotten very creative with their final wishes and what they want to have done in terms of cremation and ashes
and
services. And you can spell it out and have it followed
sure.
to your detail.
Right. Wow. Well, that's good to know. Let me ask you this. Can I use a generic power of attorney form that I can find online for free?
No.
Or do I need to go and pay for something?
It used to be, up until 2009, that the form for the power of attorney in New York was relatively simple.
Mm-hmm.
Even in our office, which had additional provisions in it, it still only amounted to a 3-page document. But in 2009, the state legislature changed the law mm-hmm. in New York, and they enacted a new form with a whole series mm-hmm. of very complicated protections for people in the document.
Mm-hmm.
So in our office, our power of attorney form, believe it or not, Tim, went from 3 pages to 15 pages.
Oh, really?
So if you're shopping around on one of those online providers
right.
that says, oh, LegalZoom, you can get your
yes.
power of attorney,
sure.
be very careful.
Be careful.
And mm-hmm. I used to answer this that, well, you don't really need an attorney to do a power of attorney mm-hmm. in New York.
Mm-hmm.
In 2009, my answer changed.
It all changed.
Yeah.
In 2009.
Today, the power of attorney literally is more complicated than your will.
Is that right?
Absolutely.
Wow.
Especially in New York with this new form.
Sure.
They call it the statutory short form, but that's kind of an oxymoron at this point.
Right. So be very careful if you're looking at something like that.
Yes.
And your advice is to,
yeah.
to seek out
the
some
power
professional
of attorney
help.
Now comes in two pieces. You have the main power of attorney,
right.
which has its own complications
yes.
because you can appoint monitors. So
right.
you can appoint an agent and then have a monitor appointed
yes.
to look over the agent's shoulder.
Yes.
And in some cases where people don't have trusted advisors or agents that they completely trust, they'll appoint maybe a son or daughter and have their accountant review the transactions just to make sure things are going
sure.
appropriately. That's a monitor. You
sure.
can put that in the basic power
sure.
of attorney. You can compensate your agents. There's a place where your agents can get paid for the services that they perform on your behalf.
Oh.
All of that goes right into the basic power of attorney document.
Right.
And then if you want your power of attorney to be able to make gifts,
mm-hmm.
and very often when we're doing planning, we want to have agents that could do anything that we could do.
Mm-hmm.
So if I need to do tax planning or Medicaid planning or some of the things mm-hmm. where I need to shift assets,
yes.
the basic power of attorney doesn't even convey that authority.
Oh.
You need to do a statutory rider.
Okay.
Which is another 6 or 7
okay.
pages,
right.
which you have to initial 3 times.
Uh-huh.
You have to have it witnessed by 2 independent witnesses
wow.
and notarized.
Wow.
So that rider actually has all of the exact same formalities as a will.
Oh.
So executing the power of attorney now has become far more complicated than it ever was before.
I guess so, yes. Let's go to some of our questions that are coming in right now. And let's see this. I thought I was missing one here, but I guess I've got them all. The first one is, can I change my healthcare proxy once I've created one?
Absolutely. virtually any of the documents I just mentioned, the healthcare proxy, the living will, the power of attorney, the disposition of remains appointment, as long as you retain capacity, you can change these documents at any time. With the healthcare proxy, I'll add that you get asked to do a new healthcare proxy every time you go to the hospital. They'll give you the form in your admissions packet for the healthcare proxy.
Right.
So when you go to the hospital, bring your healthcare proxy with you. You only need to do it once. You don't need to do it every time you go to the hospital. And you don't want to do it when you're being wheeled down to surgery down the hospital hallway. You want to have it thought about. You want all of your provisions and instructions to be in there in addition to the bare appointment of the agent. So get your healthcare proxy done, get it done comprehensively, and have it with you at the point in time if you're going into the hospital for a planned event. We have actually given our healthcare proxy to clients on a laminated card that they carry with them, just like you do organ donation on your driver's license.
Yes.
You carry your healthcare proxy with you so that when you do go to a hospital, if it's an emergency,
right there.
You have it right there.
Got it.